What's up, guys?
Hey!
It's the Normies. We're back for Vikings Season 3, Episode 9, Breaking Point. And, man, I've been waiting for this one because I want to see the conclusion to all the fuckery that happened last episode.
So how close are we to the end of the season?
There's only one more.
Second to last, right?
This is the second to last.
This is 3x9?
This is 3x9.
What's this called?
Breaking Point.
Oh. I imagine that Ragnar and the gang, they're going to hit a...
Breaking point,
if you will.
I think Paris will.
Ooh.
Well, I think both
I think Paris
sides actually,
the breaking point.
Actually, I retract that. Both sides are going to reach a breaking point.
That's true. And I'm also curious to... Well, it seemed like Floki was the most challenged last episode because the whole thing was based around him and it was his failure. Helga left him. He's really pissed and down. And so, I don't know.
He believes.
I think the Ragnar Floki thing is going to happen.
How have they not broke yet?
Well, it's... last time, were you guys saying that you didn't think Ragnar knew that Floki had killed Athelstan, or did you think he knew?
By the end of the thing, I still don't know. Like, I
the
mean,
fury
yeah.
of a patient
I mean, because it's so
obvious.
Ambiguous. Yeah, well,
but,
it's so ambiguous
to Ragnar,
the way
it's like
that...
he's the only guy who wanted to kill him.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, true.
Well, during that specific point in time, since
who would else have had the balls to do it?
Well... he was being very flamboyant with his god, if you will. So a lot of people during that time did not like Athelstan.
Yeah.
But who would have the balls to do it? That's the question.
Or the only person he for sure did tell is Helga, and maybe Helga told Ragnar, and we just didn't see that happen.
Yeah. Maybe. I mean, because it's pretty ambiguous about whether he knows or not. You know, it's just like the wording is kind of like... because Floki's already done enough up to this point to really incur some wrath from the king, so...
I feel like he knows.
Well, Floki firmly believes that so. They are all being punished.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He thinks this is the gods.
Yeah. He thinks this is a direct result of what he did.
And
maybe
it is. Actually fucking insane.
It probably kind of is. If they did have Athelstan, they could have approached this a bit differently. He probably would have advised this way differently.
Yeah, he would have been like, no, don't do that.
Because I'm sure Athelstan knew, well...
Maybe something like this has been tried. He's like, oh, you guys don't know about the siege of, like, blah, blah, blah. Like, don't do this.
I'm still disappointed at the death of Athelstan, so I'm,
yeah.
I want to know what's in store for
him. He was a very strong character. I'm sad to see him go. But let's get started, guys. We're a little short on time. Serge is kind of in a hurry.
I got to see it.
He's got to see it.
Got to see it.
Space bar that puppy.
I don't understand why we failed, Ragnar.
He's saying no.
The others will try again tonight.
Do you like even numbers?
Who's the others? Why are they trying again tonight? What are they trying again tonight?
But enough beating around the bush. If you know, you know. Tell them. Fucking talk about it. Like, you're in the middle of an invasion and it's not going well.
Well, you gotta use everything to your advantage. So the downfall of somebody like Floki, you definitely gotta use to your advantage.
I mean, if Ragnar knows, I mean, he's definitely already let a bunch of people die.
She's in the woman hit squad. They're fucking...
They're going to be like, what are they doing? Nah, they just like park. They're just climbing this? Yeah.
Oh, there's like...
barnacles?
Lagertha has gone Sam Fisher.
Silent.
Why is Lagertha always with that slimy dude? Oh, fucking
so
shank him.
Why didn't they just do this?
I think it's the girls here.
They should have done this from the beginning.
This is so cool.
She's got the assassin squad.
In the shadows. Damn, look at her using the shadows. That's awesome.
There it is.
They're on the bridge.
Damn.
Yeah, it's too late. They're literally across the bridge.
Shit. You weren't supposed to hear that.
Man,
shit.
Fucking oil.
And now they're gonna set it on fire. Get away, get away, get away, get away, get away.
I pray to God and our Holy Mother that they will not get in. But if God forbid they were to do so, make sure they do not capture you alive.
Damn.
God!
Damn. Right on.
Oh, shit.
Oh, shit.
Oh,
shit.
Dude, they
dude,
were
fucking
straight. They were fucking
I know this is, like, close to the medieval times. That's some medieval shit
But that is genius.
But you can see where it is.
Oh, my God.
Why don't they jump?
You can see where it is.
I mean, like, they gotta be strong, right?
Shield. I mean, do something.
There's nothing you can do against
it.
You gotta try.
No, it stops. There's
look
a trick.
Bro, there's nothing you can do against that.
Bro, grab the handles on the sides. Grab the handles on the sides.
Oh, my
grab the sides.
God.
Damn, that is some...
That's fucking brutal.
Shit. All right. France.
They were some fucking...
And who said France can't fight? Who said the French don't win wars?
They were fucking dastardly, dude. That's fucked up.
I mean, against the Vikings, at least. I mean, they knew how to defend.
Oh,
those people are still alive.
That is
fucking Loki.
They're saying retract and throw it again.
Oh, hell yeah, Rolo. Oh, hell yeah, bro. Push right back to the... Or what is he doing? Is he climbing over it?
He's riding back.
Oh... Okay.
He threw that under. He's gonna stop it because Rolo's actually got a fucking brain.
Why don't they shoot Rolo right now?
Yeah, shoot him in the back. They can't see him.
Maybe
no,
not.
They can't see down the tunnel. I mean, they might.
Oh yeah, they can't really see.
Meanwhile.
Oh my god. Yeah, that's not good, man. That's internal bleeding.
I don't think that was blood.
Oh, it's just vomit. Oh. There could be any number of things wrong with him right now.
I mean, he's fucked up.
I think Reiner's might be dying.
I thought I would not have to plead, not when you heard that our beloved city was in mortal danger.
This guy dies.
And why did you think that, Trey?
Because I know what your grandfather would have done.
Ooh. No, shots fired.
Oh, shit. His grandfather wasn't a pussy.
His grandfather was a...
Charlemagne.
I am not like my grandfather.
Oh, you wanted to be a fucking few episodes ago.
I am a cow.
This show is not fucking around.
Not anymore.
No, this is some crazy shit, man. This is like an episode-long battle.
Right after, like, one that we already had. I'm caught in the middle. I'm rooting for both. Because the French hype
me up. Falling back now?
Yeah.
But...
Roll out!
Good job,
bro.
Fuck.
Oh, no.
Oh, this
no.
dude's getting it.
Oh, no. What was his name?
I don't know, but he was kind of cool.
He's like a classic idea of a Viking.
Cymric? They got Cymric?
Really take business.
Keeping him alive.
Yeah, he is. Keeping them both alive.
Yeah.
Very nice.
All right, Cymric.
Even Cymric playing his cards close to his chest.
Cool. I'm glad our boy didn't get smoked.
No, or he could be there.
Dying.
Or he could be there.
No.
Drowning in his own blood because he punched
him. Never mind. Oh, no, that's not real.
He's like, I can't.
No, nah, he didn't reach out because that was really Odin reaching out.
He's battling between Jesus and Odin.
Yeah, man, it's he's his faith.
A lot because he can't choose. Oh. He knows he can't choose both.
What the fuck? That's the Viking.
Right. No, he's looking at himself.
Yeah, he's looking at the Viking version, or like the like the Norse.
Thing.
Yeah. I don't know.
Yeah, like one
he's having a struggle of faith.
One half of him is dying. That's cool. That was a cool little way to show that.
There was someone else. I have never seen a man of such strength and such violence.
Rollo.
Yeah.
His name is Rollo. He is a famous warrior.
Yeah, he's the brother of the famous warrior.
Like a crazy bear.
Crazy bear. This
man. Wait.
Bear.
Yeah, that's crazy.
And this arrow? Damn.
So Bjorn is not the bear?
Maybe the bear will marry a princess?
If you care for me at all, Count Odo, you will bring me his head.
Damn.
Yep,
he's
gonna marry
her.
No.
Jeez. No way, man. Oh shit. Well, okay.
But the seer did say if you knew what the gods had in store for you.
Hey, that's true.
Yeah.
I've promised you faithfully that I will protect you and your sons, especially Alfred. My protection I freely offer. But there must be recompense.
Some reward.
Of course.
This is like a bad porno.
Some reward.
Brazzers.
Get the logo shot.
Go now, before you get your ear full.
He has been in the marketplace denouncing our gods.
Ooh, you came to the wrong neighborhood.
Why do you do that?
It's true that I beg the people here to desist from worshipping false gods. God the Father. The Son and the Holy Ghost are the one God. The rest are just false idols.
You didn't come with like a group or like.
Why would you do this? did you want to commit suicide?
Martyrdom.
Why? Why is this even happening? We're just gonna see him get gutted. What's the point of this?
What the fuck?
His God's gonna give him strength to be able to hold it.
What is he tripping on? How is he able to do this?
I guess he draws.
Where's all the smoke at?
His skin should be like searing off a little bit.
Now. Yeah, that's like to the bone that's... now. What? Wait, what?
He's a Targaryen.
There's some trickery afoot.
What? Shut no. What? Get the fuck out of here.
Oh, it was like, oh.
Dude, a second. Yeah, no, that's what he wanted to happen.
Okay, that's hilarious.
Oh, that's way better.
That's the reality.
That's what happens.
Snap back to reality. Oh, there goes
spaghetti. Man. That's hilarious. That was,
what did he all think right. was going to happen? Why did he even...
Kind of a weird scene to throw in there with all this
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah, I wonder what that
on.
Was all about. Oh shit. Right. Oh man, right in the neighborhood.
Yeah, you could be right.
Yeah, he is. He's totally going to pull back. Oh, please. Please pull back. Don't make me a liar.
This dude's down.
Ha!
He's laughing his ass off.
That's great.
What? Whoa, shit!
That was the
oh, you gotta love the Vikings, man.
That's awesome.
And he doesn't give a fuck. Cause it, like,
what's that guy's name?
He has to go
one Siegfried.
God, they make like when their like limbs get chopped off, they make it look really like.
Man, they show the bones.
And... Visceral limb.
That was almost worse than the ear.
Lol. No, the ear, her acting.
Yeah, yeah.
It was her screaming that was more
yeah,
hard to watch.
Yeah, that was... ooh.
Is the reward what I think it is?
I want you to be my mistress.
Yeah, that's so gross.
What a grody person with this fucking, like, surfer necklace on. Like.
Yeah, like, what are you, fucking Aeropostale, like, dude bro? Like, from, like
he looks up. Like the dude bro. Look at him.
He's gonna fuck her in the ear hole.
Oh, God. Oh, well, they're sick.
Oh, well, he had a great laugh, okay? Hey, I'm sorry. Dude, that was a great
belly
laugh.
Laugh before he went out.
Good. Right in front of the king. Right in front of everybody. Just to show them what they're dealing with. What kind of people they're dealing with.
Jacques has to run around for the rest of his life missing a hand.
He won a great victory.
They're going to starve him out.
Who knows? The next time they may well succeed. Your Highness,
you're malnourished.
We have lost too many good men. I believe we must attempt to come to terms with them. Yep. There is, alas, no other way.
Father, I beg you. Ignore this counsel of despair. We should never give in to these vile pagans, to these brutes. Otherwise we will have failed.
Yep.
And that is how we would be judged.
I give thanks to God for your success and safe return.
It's a little worse than Littlefinger, I'm sorry. Yeah, Littlefinger is creep.
It's fucking gross,
but
man.
That's not cool.
Queen Quenthrith tried to use her female wiles upon me, but with God's help I managed to resist the devil's snares.
No, God.
I'm sure your wife is also happy to hear that you avoided temptation.
Of course, but I'm not so much of a hypocrite as to say so.
What happened between you and Athelstan was God's
will. Can he be ruled to death by that giant?
Meanwhile, Ekbert is just like...
They didn't have TV back in the day.
What the fuck? But that's his own son.
Dude, he doesn't care about him.
I need to ask you whether you were prepared secretly to let Quenthrith kill me as the price you were prepared to pay for the conquest of Mercia.
Oh, yeah. Damn. She likes this.
I was not.
He looks like he's fucking bullshitting, though. Good actor.
Like crying on demand like
he's
that.
He's selling it to this poor sap, but we see right through it.
What I intend to pass on to you is not only the kingdom of Wessex, but the kingdom of England. To my father.
Nah, he knows.
The most loving and true father in the world.
Nah, he knows. He knows. Yeah. He's kind of playing him back now.
You think so?
I think so.
I wonder if, what she's thinking.
No, she's like...
Yeah.
He's playing him back now.
Now, Keith.
You think so?
Yeah, dude, look at his eyes. And so they sat there for an uncomfortable silence for the next 5 minutes.
And so the dinner was eaten in a rather uncomfortable silence.
Cedric, I am saddened to see you a prisoner.
The Franks want to discuss a way to end the siege. The Count suggested a meeting take place outside the city walls.
Tell them I'll have the answer tomorrow.
Ah, yeah, we'll take him back.
Can't have our people.
Unless y'all want to fight about it.
Yeah, yeah.
Which you're clearly not in a position to do.
What should we make any kind of deal with them?
We've lost nearly 1,000 men. We can't breach the city, and winter is coming. Do you need more reason?
Winter is coming.
Harry comes finally.
You have the floor, Ragnar.
I did not become ill because I aspired to be one. It came about because of other people's actions. I did not become king out of ambition, but once again, as a result of other people's action.
Look at this.
Yeah, you fuck, you slimy son of a.
I am king. King Ragnar.
Damn, he's going. He's losing it.
No, he's not losing it. He's just
a little
breaking point. Yeah.
And as a ruler, I have the last say. Nay! Not you! Not you! Not you! And not you!
You're cool. Fuck you.
Oh, damn. Right up close.
You've all had your ideas. And they have all failed.
Yeah, because you weren't leading.
Yeah, you weren't giving them first, bro.
No, they wanted to do it. He's teaching a lesson.
Oh, no, there's he. That's
bad. No more discussion. We shall meet the Franks tomorrow.
I just want to get inside that fucking city.
Dang, he is getting big. That was the youngest one, so the other kids must be like...
That's our brother Boneless.
10 or 11.
What should we do with the Christian?
Kill him.
Kill him.
Well, there you go. Nikki, she heard you. As she coddles her baby.
As she knows me.
Kill him. Make it painful.
Seriously, man, like, what was your plan? Why were you there? Without a group, without a buddy system.
Ragnar is not here. He's already left.
Oh, shit.
Sasha.
What was that, like, the fucking tent of, like, the main cast?
I want to be baptized.
He doesn't understand.
I am a dying man, and when I die, I want to be reunited with my Christian friend, who happens to be in your heaven.
Damn.
What?
We're supposed to be Christian, retrovert.
What?
This is a man of God.
Do it right there.
Here's water. Am I wrong? You will do it here. And you will do it now.
Damn, he's fucking...
He's serious. He knows he's on his deathbed.
This is interesting. Like, imagine if it was like...
Deus tut pei.
If they come up and see this at the last moment...
They're gonna be pissed.
Soak that beer. Get a nice soak in there.
Oh!
I mean, that's your king.
He's like, well, it doesn't feel like it. Guess I'll see you soon, obviously.
They weren't supposed to see it.
Yeah, they weren't supposed to see them.
Ooh. What the fuck?
Last episode.
Another fantastical episode.
Oh, that was so good.
Oh my
Surge,
god.
Surge, fuck it. Watch the next episode.
You got it's perfect timing. We got 15 minutes to pump out a discussion, so wow.
Oh, I mean, you guys make it long. That was packed. That was, oh my
another
god.
Incredible episode filled with action, filled with stealth missions, filled with baptisms.
Oh god, this whole episode. Like, the very opening scene when they were fucking going through the shadows and, like, ducking and disappearing and hiding the bodies.
That was sick.
That was dope.
It felt like a totally different episode. Like,
or a different show.
Yeah.
I mean, for that, that part.
I just didn't expect it to go there. Like, I thought they were gonna resupply, kind of figure out what they had. I didn't know they were gonna press.
I mean, they don't have anything.
I mean, because like the tactics is always hit them hard and hit them again before they have time to recoup. Yeah,
and like a stealth hit was a wise choice.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a good.
No, I'd say they starved him out. That was it.
Yeah, I was going to mention, like, it's cool they were mentioning, like, we're running out of food and, like, supplies. It's like, it's the inner workings of, like, how...
Well, the disease that is also, like, going through the city, that's that ravaged the Vikings. They've probably developed a certain kind of immunity to it now, or the people that at least survived it won't be affected by it.
Oh, that's what you think again. They brought back?
And, yeah, I mean, hell, the Europeans brought smallpox to the Native Americans.
We were just carriers, yeah.
Yeah, and essentially that's what the Vikings are at this point. So
yeah. It makes sense.
Yeah, because if they haven't gone through the bubonic plague yet, then they don't have the genetic resistance to viruses that Europeans developed.
That's cool how we saw
especially
that
Norsemen and how they live and just how they are.
I mean, well,
they're probably resilient to
lots never,
of...
Well, they've never... They don't live... tightly bundled like Paris, because you'll find immunities to viruses and bacterias in cities that you will not find in people that live in countrysides. Because Paris, I mean, you gotta think they're closed off. They're walking outside of the, you know, in the morning and dumping their chamber pot, you know, out the fucking door and down the street it goes. So they have all kinds of immunities that the Vikings don't. But as far as we can see, it's Paris that's getting fucked up. Yeah,
that's cool. That's cool that we saw that sickness. Like that was season two,
I think so.
Yeah. Oh yeah. And now it's like kind of not a payoff, but like we're seeing.
That's crazy.
That's still relevant.
Damn, yeah. That's crazy.
This is season three. Wait, what were you talking about?
When we lost the daughter, that was a different. Like we're able to make the connection that the sickness they're facing is what was.
Could have possibly been the same thing.
Not necessarily.
I don't know. I feel like you're on the right path.
Yeah. Who knows? Yes.
What was the name of Bjorn's sister?
Yeah, we don't care. Did you do that on purpose? Do you know it?
No.
Except for the G.
Giza?
No.
Gita. Yes. Gita. Yeah.
Because I remember it sounded like smoked Gouda.
And
cheese.
She died in
hungry.
Season two.
Nobody remembers Gita.
Because you
No,
oh,
I'm
yeah,
pretty sure she died season one.
Okay, can we talk about Ragnar being like a Christian?
Yeah,
that's crazy.
Ragnar straight up is wearing a cross.
Ragnar's baptism.
Why did he do that?
Because what he said, he wants to see.
He is the king. If he believed himself to be Odin this whole time. He's obviously...
Not descended from Odin.
Descended?
Yeah, descended.
Okay, but still... Odin. But you obviously have strong ties to your own faith. I'm just surprised.
People change. No, people grow.
No, because remember on the boat when he was talking with Athelstan, he's like, if it wasn't for my sons, I wouldn't come back here. He doesn't give a shit about his kingship, I feel like.
Yeah, you know, he doesn't give it... I mean, like...
He just wants to see Paris.
Ass,
yeah.
His big-ass speech. You know, I became an earl through other people's actions. I became a king through other people's actions. Yeah. I was left no choice. I'm here to survive. And if, you know, a choice is going
to,
you know,
and
take
he
me
wants
to
see his
or...
friend. Yeah, that's so cool. I don't know. That was pretty cool.
I honestly,
that phrase about power being thrust upon you.
Yeah.
Sexy. but
not a good look for the Vikings, especially your son, yeah. Your ex, your brother, no, bro. Like why are you doing this right now?
Yeah, I don't know if he did want them to see it or didn't want them to see it.
He didn't.
His eyes
did
said he didn't want
yeah,
to see
yeah, I
it.
Think that's why he left without him.
Yeah,
probably
to go early.
Care of.
What a trooper, man. Internally bleeding, but he's still standing there, marched over there.
Yeah, he's fucked up.
He
man.
Gave a king speech, you know what I mean? Yeah. Like still
his organs are something's ruptured. Like he's constantly
he's fucked up.
I can't believe he's like standing still.
Yeah, cuz he fell, hit that wall and then fell into the water.
So God. Real quick, I had, like before I go, you mentioned something about Loki's downfall being an advantage to Ragnar, like for everyone.
Well, I mean, like, and because what we've seen of Ragnar so far is that he uses everything to his advantage. You know, either that be acting like he doesn't know something, or like he does know something. And this circumstance of using that against Floki, maybe he does know Floki, but in all honesty, I don't think he does. It was just like I said, he's done plenty of stuff to piss Ragnar off. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, what's the wrath of a patient man is he's getting baptized now. And to be, you know, he's in their religion and he wants to go to heaven. And he understands through Athelstan that you can't just go off and commit a murder. Mm-hmm. So, you know, is his wrath going to be taken out because of Athelstan? And if not, then, you know, who knows?
Interesting.
I think he's more or less at this point in time, the wrath of a patient man, I think, is applying to all of the people that are constantly second guessing him and that are constantly giving him shit for the decisions he's made. Because he's given everybody an opportunity now to kind of show them what they're made of, and they've all fucked up. Mm-hmm. Like, nobody has really gotten them ahead. The only thing that is really even getting them this deal in the first place is a lack of supplies and disease.
And nothing that they did.
Yeah. So,
I mean, they fought pretty valiantly.
Absolutely. I mean, if they had...
With the wheel.
But they still had to retreat. They still had to
end up retreating. Yeah, even at the end of the day, taking a city, if you don't have people, the people are going to take you.
Right.
You know, so, and Paris is obviously a huge city. So if you come in, take out the military, now you need to set up your enforcement over that city. You can't do that.
Yeah, they won't be able to occupy it.
A few hundred
people. Something
realistic siege.
I don't know, man. The French citizens don't seem like they would be that willing to jump right on them.
I thought the French always lost wars, and they're over here bouncing
back.
But the
same, like, I don't think that them attacking didn't help, like, because it's like everybody else tried and they failed, but didn't get them anywhere. But it did, because if they didn't attack them, then they would still have the full supplies, they would still have full food, it wouldn't have that disease just yet. So, sure, everybody's plans didn't work, but it did help, because now they've lost some of the supplies that they had. Because they didn't even use the big bolts again. They had to break out that wheel thing. I wonder why.
Yeah, yeah.
It was already a bit lofty to try to take Paris of Ragnar anyway. And he was kind of selfish for just wanting to literally see it. And, like, he saw it, you know.
He's there for himself. He's just using his position. He's using, and that kind of goes back, he's using everything to his advantage. You know, like he's... Yeah, I mean, he's a man that has come from the bottom, and he understands where you can get leverage. Whereas somebody who's, you know, flooded in leverage, but at the same time, you know, just opportunities, but at the same time isn't hungry. He's hungry. He sees opportunities that you or I are not going to see, because he understands how he can use it to his advantage, because he's like, you can make something from nothing. And that's what he's operating with. Mm-hmm. And because he went from a farmer to a fucking king. You know, yes, choices from other people put him in a position that he had to make a choice, but farmer to king. Everything was used.
I forgot what I was going to say. The big arrows, I guess maybe they only had a finite number of those, because Rollo found the old ones in the bridge and used those to block the wheel.
Which doesn't make any sense.
Well, that, and we've like already seen it before. They probably just wanted to show us something else that was kind of cool.
That was fucking brutal.
That was
cool scene.
That was rough. That was one that...
You could still have fired off the bolts first and then use that thing.
I've never seen someone so strong and violent.
Like a bear.
Like a crazy bear.
I mean, well, like, yeah, Simric is like, he fights like a bear.
As soon as he said that, wait a minute.
Yeah, and you know, and like, that was intentional. Bjorn, you know,
if you would have never said that, that line would have just passed us by. We're like, yeah, he does fight like a bear.
Maybe,
Oh, no, because the seer says bear will marry the princess.
And Rollo would laugh if he knew what the gods had in store.
What the fuck?
You got some twist on us.
Can I say that
he really wanted to kill that girl.
The whole random scene with the priest in Kattegat coming in.
felt a little disjointed.
I was trying to think, why did they put that in there? I'm trying to think of any reason thematically. And I'm trying like
that Christianity like, is growing.
Look at
when
the way
you're at
his
UA
society,
territory. Like, I don't know. Like,
what I'm saying is, look at the way his society treats Christians. Already. And their king just converted. That's a big deal.
True. I didn't even make that connection.
Very good, yeah.
So,
yeah,
I didn't think about that.
I mean, and it, like, literally just so nonchalantly as I tuck my child in.
Kill him.
You are an ant, and their king just converted.
Yeah.
That was a funny scene, though, when he was, like, fantasizing about, like...
Yeah, his god.
Yeah, I was like, oh.
It's like, how do you do that?
And I'm like, props, he made it all that way.
Yeah.
I mean,
oh, God.
That's harder than I probably
would. He talked a big game. You can't talk a big game like that and not go at least a few steps. But okay, let's go to
got it. That was a cool way to go out though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. That was pretty gruesome.
That's great.
Let's go to Wessex and Eckbert and
Love Triangle. I didn't write any notes on that.
Judas fuck. And I think Aethel Wolf is playing him back now, or at least he's
aware.
I don't
think he's smart enough to.
Or at least he's aware of his.
My question is because everybody doesn't know. Only Floki knows. That the settlement, Floki and Ragnar are the only ones that know about the settlement getting completely wiped out.
We still haven't seen a conclusion.
So, and we don't know at this point. I mean, Ragnar expects himself to die. So we don't know if he's even going to make it back to Kattegat. So, you know, when they find out that shit happened over in Wessex, Ragnar's not going to be able to talk any sense into him. Well,
if he...
The only reason he stopped that news from getting out in the first place is because he wanted to go to Francia, but there's not going to be any person holding those reins when they find out.
But Eckbert is a huge slimeball. He's just
I'm not sure why he's doing. Why is he's keeping Alfred so close and like
why does he give a shit about Alfred? Like
He really did like Athelstan.
Yeah. Plus, he's gonna get rid of Aethel.
But that's actually these are historically accurate characters. But Alfred was not the son of a monk or Athelstan's son. Actually, in reality,
I know that the king.
Eckbert?
Alfred will be the new heir.
Yes, we'll go with that. King Eckbert.
Did you just like...
I was trying to... I'm just going to shut up. So King Eckbert, though I am not familiar with his exact doings in the creation of the Kingdom of England, I am familiar with some of his progeny. So he didn't just like Athelstan. He kind of revered Athelstan as this great intellectual and suave, there was more, he said he kind of almost fetishized him to a point. So Alfred has a very special place in his heart because he's the progeny.
I mean, look who Athelstan is. He's a godly person that has survived and lived with these, savages.
But he doesn't give a fuck about anybody else except that baby.
Well, because I think at the same...
Your baby would have that luck behind it. You know, if anything, you know that child is something
special.
Still,
it just seems strange, I guess.
Yeah.
Athelstan. Now, granted, I doubt that Eckbert is aware of Athelstan's martyrdom, but the show really portrayed him to be a martyr like that. Now, granted, anybody could be a martyr, whatever. Devil's advocate. But to be a martyr was a very, very big deal, especially in that era of Catholicism. Mm-hmm. So.
And he took it right to the.
You have a martyr's baby.
But they don't know that. They don't know he's dead.
They don't know that. But that just compounds to the reverence that's already been shown to Athelstan.
I mean, we know that stuff matters, or we're at least supposed to think that it matters because the seer exists and these prophecies exist in the show, you know, so it's worth talking about.
Right.
The seer and Sinric is a... Man, how much of an advantage is it to be, bilingual or multilingual in that time period?
Oh, he knows tons of languages.
I'm just a wanderer, just to know every language.
Does that mean he likes guys and girls?
Probably.
He's a pretty ambiguously looking character.
I don't know what his pronoun
is. Their lip liner.
He identifies as a wanderer.
I think that's him. Like, he hasn't had the time to fix it in a long time. He's been a prisoner, and then...
You can say it, they...
Oh, man. Let's just finish this.
Oh, man.
We got one more episode left in season 3.
We are on the finale, and... I am gonna be the buzzkill, and I'm gonna get out of here.
He's gonna go see.
Oh, see, there we go.
I didn't know we were planning on two.
No, we were planning on one. I just didn't expect that one to be so good.
All right, guys.
See y'all.
See you next time.
So see you guys.
Farewell.
Ragnar is a Christian. Fucking Athelstan. Thank you, Luis, Joe, Abel, David, Toy Soldier, and Amanda for continuing to be our super patrons. Can't believe we are already at the season 3 finale. See you there.